The 42nd annual Hawaii Film Festival kicked off tonight with a special screening of Made in Hawaii movies at the Bishop Museum. One movie, called The Wind and the Reckoning, brings home Hawaii-born actor Jason Scott Lee. Kamaka Pili has more.
This evening, the 42nd edition of the Hawaii International Film Festival kicks off here on the Great Lawn of Bishop Museum with its first film screening. And the beautiful thing about this season's kickoff is screenings are focusing on Made in Hawaii and Pacific films. And this evening's screening is of the film The Wind and the Reckoning. And I'm so stoked to introduce our guest. You may recognize him from films such as Jungle Book, Mulan, and the list can go on and on. Jason Scott Lee, thank you very much for your time.
Hi.
Tell us a little bit about this. I mean, The Wind and the Reckoning. What is the story behind this film?
Well, the story is taken from the island of Kauai, and it's the account of Kaluai Ko'olau and his wife Pi'ilani and their son Kalaimanu, and how they were Ko'olau, the husband, and his son were stricken by the Hansen's disease, by leprosy. During that time, right at the 1893, the provisional government stepped in, so the family wasn't going to be allowed to stay together. They were shipping people off to Molokai. So it's a story of their rebellion against the provisional government's orders and laws. And they fled into the Kalalau Valley to find respite and stay away from people.
Why do you think this story is important to share? And what may be some things that attracted you to participate in it?
You know, after reading the script in different forms, in its big budget form, medium budget, small budget, to our film, which was on a micro budget, you know, it was really the time and place to make it happen. And I say the time and place to make it happen because the film works on so many different levels. There's so many great messages and themes in it. There were so many things that that, you know, made it difficult, especially the language. 80% of the film is in Olelo Hawaiian, and I'm not a native speaker, and I was never educated in the Hawaiian language, so it was the most challenging, I think, thing in my career as an actor, with working with dialogue. It's one thing to learn it, but it's another thing to perform it. And so those are the things that, like, man, you know, it's like we kind of like pat ourselves on the back, myself and the other actors who did speak in the show, because I think we grabbed an authenticity. We grabbed the language of the time, and not you know, not modern. So there's so many things we had to work on to make that seem true.
I've been hearing great compliments about this, from Olelo to the scenes and the nature that's included and intertwined within the Mo'olelo and the story itself. But for you, what is your hopes that if somebody sits in this and watches this film as an audience member and gets to walk away being Hawaiian or not Hawaiian, from Hawaii or not, what are you hoping that they walk away with?
I think they'll recognize that all indigenous cultures, and especially the Hawaiian culture and Hawaiian language, is a heart language. There's a sound to it, there's a cadence to it, there's a rhythm that, you know, even when you're hearing it and you're seeing the subtitles and you're not understanding what it's saying, but there's a feeling behind the language that when you see the translation, it's a very poetic way of speaking. And I think that's something that, you know, gets lost. And hopefully, you know, the feelings will have a lasting impression.
That's awesome. That's beautiful, because the old time, you get to really embrace that poetry, which we don't necessarily embrace today. Thank you very much. You know, this is so cool. First time I got to meet him, so I'm really stoked about that. But if you couldn't make it this evening, here on Oahu, you have three chances to catch this film. This Friday, Saturday, Sunday at Consolidated Ward Theaters. And if you're on Kauai, Maui, or on Hawaii Island, from November 17th through the 30th, you'll have the chance to watch screenings on your home island. For those dates, times, and all the information of this festival and this film, be sure to visit our website, khon2.com. Kamaka Pili with KHON2 News, with Jason Scott Lee.
Aloha.
Back to you guys in studio.